and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Vicky, and in today's video, we're going to be going over the March sinking funds. And like any other YouTuber who's filmed and then something crashed or your battery died, yep, I finally experienced that. So I actually did this whole video and I was talking through it and realized I'm not recording. And so I don't know what happened, but let's just go ahead and review. So I'll go ahead and zoom in and we can talk about it. So, sinking funds. These are the, I think it's 16 I counted, sinking funds that we have. We keep them in Capital One 360. And they are in separate accounts for each category. That's how I like to do them. It just, for me, it makes it very neat and easy to keep track of. Some of these were cash envelopes at one point, and so I may turn them back into cash envelopes because I'm watching all these videos of cash envelopes and I'm missing my cash. But let's go ahead and go through these. All right, so the first one is birthdays, and it gets $50. Now, I will say that I haven't put the starting amount because I haven't closed out February yet. So it will, you know, you will see a close amount when I close out February. I'll come in and put the balances and we'll talk through how I ended up my sinking funds. But for now, we're setting up March. So birthdays gets 50, car maintenance gets 100, car registration gets 40, Christmas gets 100, date night gets 25, and the asterisk just means that this is sitting in our Wells Fargo. It is a auto transfer from our checking to our savings, and the reason for that is like we need an auto something so that we don't get a monthly charge, which is fine. Emergency fund, while I don't have an auto transfer, we are putting everything from our snowballs into the emergency fund for right now. We're just saving, you know, during COVID times. Haircuts is 60. Life Happens is 75. This one too is a Wells Fargo account. And it is another one where it, you know, it's an auto transfer from checking to savings. And I just called this Date Night and Life Happens just to give it a name. But this one gives us the opportunity to get some cash really quickly, where as opposed to Capital One 360, you have to wait 3 to 5 business days. And one of you guys in the comments had made a great suggestion about using Zelle, like transferring Zelle from my Capital One into my checking account, which makes sense, but I think it has to be a Capital One checking account. So I need to go open one of those. I just haven't done it yet. Okay, the next category is kids' clothes and kids' miscellaneous. They each get 50, and that has been a huge godsend to bring back. So I did take it away during the pandemic and then I brought it back. These might go into cash envelopes. I'm thinking I may switch that up, but I'm still buying stuff on Amazon. It's just easy to like charge it onto my Capital One Venture card and then transfer from the account into my credit card, if that makes sense. Medical gets 50. That goes to prescriptions and co-pays. Pest control gets 40. This comes out quarterly. It's about 120, a little under, maybe it's 115 a month. So that has been great to do that. School is 250 a month, and we're in public school, but this is our first year. I've never been a mom to an elementary school child, so I don't know like what kind of expenses we were expecting. And there was a lot of upfront like funds to donate to, and I know like we don't have to donate, but I kind of feel guilty. And then there's the school pictures and book drive and this, that, and the other, and I just kind of want to see which we participate with in and how much it's costing us. So for right now, I'm just gonna put park 250 a month. At the end of the year, I'll see how much we spent and then we'll readjust accordingly. That's a lot to say. This is a sinking fund for kindergarten. Sports gets $10, and we're not in any sports just yet, and I think they're opening up in our county, but we're just choosing to keep him in, or not in sports right now, but I'm still saving for when he does join a team or a club. Summer gets $50 a month, because that comes every year. And then vacation, we're not going anywhere, so we're not doing that. Okay, we do also have a home maintenance sinking fund for the three properties we own. For the one in Los Angeles, right now it's a condo, so we only put $25 there. For the home, the rental, we're putting aside $250, and for ours, we do $100. It probably should be the reverse, to be honest, but at the end of the day, if we needed to buy something for, I mean, this is all of our money, so that's fine. Okay, so with that, that is the sinking funds for March, and we'll go ahead and do the sinking funds tracker. Now, I didn't do this in the past, and I actually love it now because it's like, okay, great, you have these sinking funds, but what have you done to, like, you know, where have you spent your money? And so let me see here. I love this. So this is kind of an example of which fund I use, the amount, the date, the description of what we bought with what. And at the end of the month, I'll be closing out February to show you what that looks like. So this is our setup, and let's see if I can replicate it for the month of March. And I will speed you up for this. How we end up the month of March, please consider subscribing to the channel and giving the video a thumbs up. I'd really appreciate it. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. Bye.